Everyone, welcome, welcome. It is Thursday. Thursday. One of my favorite days. You know what I like about Thursday the most? People's minds are between introspection of what's been happening during that week and what's going to happen in the beginnings of next week. Because it's not quite Friday. Their minds are in a very interesting place most of the time. Hold on, let me fix this screen for you. There we go. Oops. Let me go previous. All righty. And look at that. Look at this fight me. Great. All right. No touch. Anyways, and the reality is Thursday's just such a good day psychologically for people to really make better decisions. How's that? And what I mean by better decisions is people are going to make decisions in some format, some way, no matter what's going on, because that's simply how that works. Hold on a minute while I test my audio. Okay, apologize one second. And is my audio working? Do you believe it is? Okay. So, apologize about that. Sometimes I have a little wrestling match here with this program. So, anyway, so Wednesday is such a good time to have deeper conversations and also to do things like ask for a sale. It's not a bad time to ask for a sale. I used to set up most of my discussions that I felt were going to be valuable to the close of a sale on Thursdays, okay? And I can tell you that it's just such a good day for you personally as well, because you're in the same position as maybe someone that's buying from you, per se, where your effective and your decisions are usually a little bit more solid, okay? I like Friday mornings for decision-making. Me and my business partner and wife, we make decisions on Tuesdays that are major that may move the company in one direction or another. And I like doing it Friday morning because you're just fresh from that introspective Thursday, right? And that's a good day. I feel like I've made better decisions because of that. So you're here for the Morning Mindset. I am Beto Paredes. You can learn more about me at BetoParedes.com. If you would like to join us here at 7 a.m. Pacific Standard Time or 10 any given day, we're here for you. I'd love to have you join us. Go to tinyurl.com/MMS today. So let's get into it. Thursday subject. As I told you, yes, I may take another in here and talk more about the Success Attitude by Jack Ziegfeld. I've learned with so much good stuff that you can learn from a personal development performance trainer. And I like a lot of them. You know, really do love Tony Robbins. Really do like a lot Jack Ziegfeld as well. And I like the idea of these simple formulas, okay? So he has this formula he calls the Success Attitude, which is Success Attitude equals your core desires plus direction. And before we even go anywhere else, core desires plus direction. You know, I understood his concept of going through the process of discovering what a core desire was, okay? And a lot of times you'll hear others talk about desires in many different ways. You know, are they useful? Are they not useful? Are they in your way? Are they the main purpose of your life? And what I love about Jack's system isn't that your core desires themselves, once understood, was the most important part of the process. It's that when you understood them, you reach some perception. You get into this state of understanding your personal needs, okay, in a different format to a degree. It reminds me of Tony Robbins talking about outcomes. What are the outcomes that you want? Okay, well, you can look at these core desires as outcomes that you are working towards, that you want in your life. What are the outcomes that you would like to have? That's part of the Robbins RP brilliant formula. But the success attitude here, core desires, understanding those, plus direction. Okay, because even if you have a clear conception, through at least 8 fairly focused degree of what it is that you feel. That isn't enough. Direction. You got to have a strategy, direction. Give it. You have to give it potential opportunity to actually. So core desires plus direction. It's what it ain't about what you really want in your relationships, in your business, in your personal life, in your health. What is it? I used to tell people when I would explain my understanding of this that it's very similar to the reductionist theory in science. Right? The core desires themselves are at like this psychological perspective of realizing them. You go through a psychology to see them. What are they? And the way Jack explains it, and I like it from the scientific perspective, is that you go from, for say in science, from psychology, right? And that drops down from psychology to, I do believe it is biochemistry, okay, biology. And then from there, actually, I think it's actually psychology, biology, chemistry, and really quantum mechanics, quantum physics. If any of you are familiar with what quantum mechanics, quantum physics really is, it's not a division of physics, it is physics. And all physics should, in all ways and most perspectives, actually reduce down to that potential because it's the framework of physics. So core desires are like the framework of your personal action-based state. You're acting in such ways because you're trying to achieve an outcome. It is a natural process that we go through. Okay, so your understanding of these core desires is absolutely critical, but the way you give them meaning is direction. Okay, as Tony Robbins talks about very, very directly, meaning is your emotions with direction, right? Because you're given meaning to it. So if you're clear about your outcomes, what you really want, these core desires that you absolutely really do have, and you're clear with them, and you have direction with how these core desires will make an impact for your outcome to be realized, you're prepared. So that's the first part of it. So success attitude equals core desires plus direction. Then it's times proper action plus persistence. It's a multiplier. You know, when I looked at this, I was so kind of like astounded at the realization of how powerful it is to think dimensionally in the process of expanding something that you have in your mind, in your heart, in your soul, in your core desires to expand it and make it strong. Take it times something. Okay, multiply it. So multiplication. So in other words, the success attitude is knowing your core desires in the direction in which they exist. And then taking that and multiplying it by proper action plus persistence. That's the success attitude. Okay, if you're going to have a successful attitude, understand exactly what your core desires are, what are your outcomes that you're looking to achieve, okay, and make sure you understand them clearly. If you want to know more of how to kind of exercise that idea, Tony Robbins' RPM is great. Okay, that's a great way of doing it. You know, me and my wife, we have such a curious relationship because we, you know, we're married, but we're business partners, and our business can get intense sometimes. And one way or the other, we usually end up working together on certain things if we find something fascinating enough that it might work well for our business. And I found Tony Robbins' RPM because I keep hearing him say it. I hear him talking about it on his stuff, and I've read about it, but I wanted to get a real clear idea of just the foundations of the RPM principles. So I found it, shared it with my wife, got on to a couple other things I was doing. I came back, she was already almost completely through it. He already RPM'd a bunch of stuff. I was like, wow, hey, well, you're obviously on top of that. So that's a really good one to understand the outcomes that you have. But from Jack Zufeld's position, you've got to understand what you want. Like, introspection is critical. Just keep thinking through. If you read his book, The DNA of Success, he's got theory around how you can discover the core desires that you have. Because a lot of people are so enshrouded by their imagery in their minds from whatever perspective. Okay, if you're a fan of psychology, okay, there's a struggle in mankind to understand the connectivity between unconscious consciousness and subconsciousness. Okay, there's a real struggle there because we get addicted to certain imaginations or images within our mindset that are not helping us shape our lives. Right? They're not participating properly, but they are still very powerful. If you understand the core desires that you have, you can reshape the imagination associated with their accomplishment. And we are shaping our lives. That is what we are doing, as Tony Robbins says. This is shaping your life. So understanding your core desires plus the direction you need to realize them and then amplifying that by proper action plus persistence. Proper action. What is that exactly? Well, if you're an entrepreneur, okay, now this is, I've been having too much fun with this. I don't know if it's stage in my life or what, I'm 40, going to be 41 this year. But it's interesting, proper action. It's the absolute best possible strategic move that you can make. Okay, if you're a chess player and you're playing chess and you understand the chess pieces, you're playing very differently in that arena than you are in, let's just say, soccer. Okay, so in soccer, you're moving up the field quickly. You're looking for quick opportunities that would allow you to get to a certain part of the field and make a goal. Well, a chess player is thinking through the entire strategy to the outcome. All right, they're trying to understand how to make all of the moves on the chessboard result in an outcome that they can at least somewhat predict strategically. Somewhat predict strategically. It's why the best chess players are so incredibly good, because they've got so many patterns of successful outcomes. Okay, they have so many patterns of successful outcomes that the outcomes that they desire are almost guaranteed, unless they're playing against someone who understands the game from that level. And then it becomes a championship, right? But that's our lives. Right there, if you know your outcomes and you know what the proper actions are, your strategic moves to get there, okay, you can think much differently. I would rather spend 2 hours working on a strategy than 2 hours working on a set of goals. Okay, and when you realize that one is just really a superior form of the other, things will change for the way you see your life. Okay, work on a strategy. Proper action. Okay, take the right actions to the best of your understanding of all the steps to the outcome you're trying to achieve. Okay, plus persistence. Persistence. It's funny, I was just talking to my wife about this morning too. It's the old word for it's really prudence, right? Continual, long-stead activity that does not falter. Or at least only flickers. How's that? I flicker. Everyone flickers a little bit. Well, I'm taking an evening off. See my kids. Stretch my legs. We all flicker. But the reality is that persistence is long-standing. It's endless. It's something that some people get in them and don't even have enough of before they're dead. Because this persistence, this drive to perform, to be more, to contribute, to express. When you really become one with that, perception becomes life. And you share that with others. You share that with your family. You share and love people. That gives you a level of persistence that is longstanding for year after year after year. Make sure that the core desires that you have come all the way into your human level. Okay, core desires will never only be about a job. It may not even be about a specific industry. Could be that you just want to be very expressive somehow in a way that you create value. Maybe you're very specific about that. Okay, I have a lot of specificity. I think specificity is important. Distinctions is how it explained by Tony. You know, I have several distinctions about certain perspectives and reasons. Okay, so strategy. Okay, strategy plus persistence. Constantly be improving your strategy based off of the outcomes of the core desires that you have. That is the success attitude. So we don't have much more time today. I do appreciate you guys being a little bit patient with me. I did have to take me an extra minute because I'm on a different computer. But thanks for joining me, and I will absolutely be here again tomorrow morning.